Right. Today we're making Sharkpedos. This is awesome. You gotta have a pool or a bath. It doesn't matter. These things are super fun. You throw them in the water, they go down like a, you know, torpedo or a submarine. And as they hit the water, the fins make them spin and they glide through the water spinning. And then they rest at the bottom of the pool. Then you've got to go and swim down and find them. Or if they're in the bath, they just spin and then they sit there and you grab it and throw it again. You know, Sharkpedos, I love them. They are so much fun and they're pretty simple, but we have to figure out exactly how we're going to get it to spin, how we're going to get weight to make it go down. I'm going to use a bottle, but you can use anything. I even imagine someone could carve a wooden one that would go, and maybe you could add a piece of metal in there to make it go down. There's so many ways to make something not float. I mean, that's what you got to do. And then you got to think of that spinning action like an American football or like, you know, like a bullet as it spins through the water. And of course, there's also the shark element. So putting an eye on it, putting some gills on it, Sharkpedo, you know, it should look like that dangerous shark going through the water. Great. I'm going to have a good old go at this with Bo and Atty. I want you to do the same. Take on this challenge. Make a Sharkpedo. All right, like you, never done this before. Who in the world has made a Sharkpedo before?
Nobody.
Oh well, here we go. This is what I've gone for. I've used my bottle, I chopped it up, I got another bottle. Can you see inside there? I've got a bottle inside a bottle. Now this first bottle, I can open that, and the second bottle's sealing this about here, so I can fill this. I'm going to fill this full of sand, making this heavier, this place here. Now there's still the air at the back, so that as it's going along, hopefully it will go through the water because the weight will be pulling it down. I will have thrown it for the force. That's my plan. Now, I haven't done it before, so lots of testing. I've got to see how much air I need, how much sand I need, but I've got this now. A bottle where I can put something in that's not going to get wet and the air stays in the other side. So let's see what happens now. I fill it up. Bombing. Bomb you. This. Let's test this thing. Whoa, way too buoyant. I need so much more weight. That's rubbish.
And action.
Right. Bottle's not working, it's just too buoyant. So I've got myself a massive stick. Now this, I didn't cut it off a tree. The gardener was trimming and he trimmed it. So I never cut down trees or bushes, never do that. But if you find wood on the floor or if the gardener trims a piece because that's how you keep the tree alive and healthy and growing nicely, then that's fine. So I got this, the gardener trimmed it off and I said, I'll have that. And it's nice, it's still full of water. It's not gonna float so well and I'm gonna make my Sharkpedo out of it. You see that? This is a great opportunity because I get to, yes, use some tools, finally. Look at my knife, do you love that? It's my Mr. Maker knife. Yeah, I'm gonna whittle and I'm gonna saw. So I'm gonna saw off the Sharkpedo bit and I'm gonna whittle it down. Now I'll do most of the shape while it's in, while it's a big piece, yeah? Don't chop it down and then try and shape it. You really want to be shaping it while it's all one piece because you can hold it in lots of different ways. You can lean it up against things so that whenever you're working with it, you're far away from your body, yeah, with the cutting edge. You also, you're always cutting away from you, never towards you, never ever towards you, and always make sure your hands are behind the cutting edge so you're never cutting like this towards your hand. Yeah, that's what happens when you get a small thing and you're trying to whittle. You'll put your hand in front of the cutting edge. You'll be cutting and the force will suddenly slice and you'll get yourself. So those are the two main rules of whittling. Always away from you, yeah, never towards your body, and make sure your hands are behind the cutting edge. And in that way, you're gonna have a lot of success. Now, when you whittle, really try to do forward and slice at the same time. Forward and slice. So it's, if you press forward, it's very difficult, but if you slice at the same time, the blade does it work so much smoother, and that's how this works. Okay, cool, guys. Bit of knife skills there, bit of whittling skills. We're going to be doing lots of whittling projects. I love them. So, okay. Right. I'm going to make this Sharpedo with my massive knife, and then I'm going to test it out in the pool and see if number two works. Okay, pool time. I've made two. Sharpedo number one. I love this. I filled it full of sand and water in the top capsule. In the bottom capsule, I put some water in just to keep it so there isn't so much air in there that's going to make it go up. I love that one. I can't wait. That failed miserably the first time. Number two, my pride and joy. Carved out of a stick from that wonderful tree behind me, that one there. Yeah, the gardener cut this down. If you can get wood that's been cut down by like a gardener or somebody in trimming, you're not breaking any trees, then it's soft. It's still got moisture in it, very easy to carve. So I've carved out this torpedo shape. I'm not even gonna paint this because I want it to be in the pool. I don't want it to be like all paint in the pool and stuff, so leaving it. Then I got some aluminium, made these back rotors to make it twist. Now the whole idea here, like American football, yeah, is that if something twists, it goes faster, cuts through whatever it's going through, yeah? So if you throw the ball like that, oh, I made it all cool. If you do it like that, it's twisting in the air, it can go so far. Those guys can throw it like 100 yards. And same with the Sharpedo. If it's moving like this in the water, it cuts through as it goes. Okay, I'm getting in the pool. I've been in a couple of times, but I'm getting in the pool to show you how these work out. I'm so excited. I have no idea. I'm in. First things first, goggles on. Please be safe around the swimming pool. Yes. Right, here goes. I hope you can see them moving. Number one. Ba, ba, ba. Are you ready? And go. Oh, it's just too much air. Rats. Right, back to the drawing board with that one. But check out number two. Can't wait for this. Right, are you ready? Oh, that's awesome. Gone. Woohoo! Sharkpedo. I'm gonna see it underwater. These help you learn to dive too a lot. Okay, it's spinning, but it's spinning like slowly, like this. I've got to change the shape of the wings. I've got to maybe thinning it as well, so it's like. But that's the idea, right? I'm going to keep trying, but there's no time for you to waste. Go and make a Sharkpedo. It's cool, man. It's like a big missile. Yes, go do it, guys. Bye. Oh, don't you dare.